presence this evening, Jehovah God, because we desire more and more from you tonight, dear God. We pray, Jehovah King, of all the glories, even as we begin, Jehovah Father, this meeting, that your presence will be together with us, oh God. We commit every agenda of this meeting, Jehovah Father, into your able hands this evening. And we pray that, Jehovah King, of all the glory, you will visit us in a mighty way, Jehovah Father. We pray that your presence will dwell in us, Jehovah God. We commit our lives unto you, Jehovah Father, our hearts, our souls, and our minds, my God. And I pray that you may wash us and cleanse us by the blood of Jesus, even as we prepare to hear your word, oh God. We lift your name on high. May every praise that will be done in this place, Jehovah Father, come back to you, Jehovah Father. In Jesus' mighty name we do pray and give praise.
Let us make up our minds that we are going to worship the Lord, that we are going to leave all sin behind us, and then give our lives to His glory.
I got my mind made up, and I won't turn back, 'cause I won't see my Jesus someday.
Made up,
and I won't turn back, 'cause
standing just for a moment, because we are going to just say a corporate prayer. I want to take this opportunity on behalf of the St. Louis African Churches Fellowship, the Pastors Fellowship and the Fellowship of the Churches, our chairman, Pastor Francis Karenge. It is okay to appreciate him. As I mentioned, he has led us very well to bring us to this day, and we thank God. On behalf of the chairman and the Pastors Fellowship, we want to welcome you tonight to our final night of revival. Praise God. Have you already been blessed?
Yes.
Come on, give glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. We are expecting that tonight God is going to move even greater. Hallelujah. Turn to your neighbor and tell them, even greater.
Even greater.
Even greater. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. We have a part program, and we know that we need God to come. And we need God to move. Tonight we expect blessings. Tonight we expect impartation. Tonight we expect that God is going to touch every single man, woman, and child, every family, every congregation. Indeed, St. Louis will be touched by the name of the living God. So I want us to just lift up our hands and ask God to come and do it. We are not going to say a long prayer. Just begin to talk to God. Ask Him whatever you want Him to do tonight. Whatever you want Him to do for your family, whatever you want Him to do for your marriage, whatever you want Him to do for your son, for your daughter, what you want Him to do for your church, your neighborhood, this city of St. Louis, what can God do for America in this day and in this night? God is able to do it. We just need to ask Him. He says, ask me and I will do it for you. Knock on the door and I shall open it. Mighty and everlasting God, we welcome you in this place. God, we are expecting greater things. We are expecting a mighty anointing. We are expecting, oh God, healings. We are expecting, mighty and everlasting God, that yokes will be broken. Oh Father, in the name of Jesus, come and glorify yourself in this place. Come and magnify your presence in this place. Come and release the provisions for your people. Oh God Almighty, come and release the jobs for your people. Come and heal your people from every affliction, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Oh Father, we need you to come. Show us your glory, God. Show us your presence, oh God. Show us your goodness, oh God. We want to worship you in spirit and in truth. We want, oh God Almighty, to come out of here with a testimony that we have been in the presence of God, and that God has spoken to us, and that God has magnified His name. His name in our midst. Father, we welcome you in this place. We welcome you in this place, oh God. Mighty and everlasting God, we lift up the man of God. We lift up Reverend Peter Kamau before you. That tonight, even this moment, God, you are preparing him. That Lord, you are downloading into his heart a message for us. That mighty and everlasting God, right now you are pouring into his vessel an overflowing anointing for all your people, God. That you are releasing the rivers of heaven into this place in the name of Jesus Christ. Mighty and everlasting God, in the name of Jesus, send your spirit, oh God. Let your angels take their positions, oh God. In the sanctuary and in the city, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, come into your sanctuary. We desire you, God. We are waiting for you, God. We want you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty and holy name. And together we say, amen. I want to welcome our chairman, Pastor Karenge. You may take your seat in the presence of the Lord. Pastor Francis Karenge, you are most welcome. Come on, let's appreciate him as he comes. Mighty man of God. Amen.
Well, if you praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is an awesome night again. I believe this is the last day, but not the last day going to heaven. We are ready to go to heaven. Amen. We love you so much, and I love you so much. Amen. Praise the name of Jesus. You know, tonight we're expecting something very powerful. As we hear the word of the Lord we had yesterday about the anointing, about the presence of the Lord. And I believe when Peter went to the man by character called a beggar, he was sitting at the beautiful gate. Every day some money. And Peter came and says he was tired. He said, silver and gold have I not, but what I will give you is this one. In the name of Jesus, arise and walk. Yes. You know, have you seen people in the city somewhere when they ask you, do you have sad, do you have 15 cents? But look what Peter said, silver and gold I have not. Yes. But what I will give you, in the name of Jesus Christ, arise and walk. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Tonight, if I don't have private jet or $10,000 or a house or a job, but I know what I have is the anointing of the Lord.
Yes.
Presence of God.
Yes.
That is sufficient for me.
Amen.
That will take me everywhere I want to go.
Yes.
Because the power and the anointing of the Lord of Jesus Christ is enough for me. No worries, amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Thank you again for coming. On behalf of pastors of St. Louis, African pastors, we humbly say thank you for your cooperation, for your contribution. Thank you for coming since Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. We want to thank you so much. But tonight we want to urge you, do not leave today. Wait up to the very end. Amen?
Amen?
So please do not go. I know some of you will say, I'm going to work. But God is with you and is with us.
Amen.
So be patient today, because there is a power, something powerful for you is coming and just ready to receive. And I'd like also to extend my appreciation to intercessors. May you really raise again, intercessors. Hello? Intercessors. There is power in the prayer. Amen. This man and women of God have been praying for this meeting. Include us. Amen. Thank you very much. Good job. What about worship team? May you stand up, please. Worship team. Give them a big clap. And now, I want to take this opportunity for the men and women of God, preachers, apostles, teachers, and prophets. They are here. They met every Sunday. They left their job, their homes, take a few hours just to discuss about this meeting, how all the churches will come together, regardless of our color, regardless of our denomination. We call denomination denominator, sometimes it divides.
Yes,
but this one we say no.
Yes.
We are one. Hallelujah.
Yes.
So if you are, whatever church you are, we are one as a body of Christ. I want to congratulate all the pastors of St. Louis. If you are here, please, may you raise on your feet and come forward. Let your people see what you do. Amen. May you come forward, please?
Yeah.
All the pastors.
Thank you, Father.
As you turn around to the congregation.
Yeah.
Please just say your name and your church and your spouse. God bless you.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, brethren.
Yes.
Once again, praise the Lord.
Yes.
Come on, once again, praise the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. I'm Eunice Wamugai. Mugai is not here, but he's represented well. Amen.
Yes.
Welcome into the house of the Lord.
Amen.
We serve him.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
My name is Pastor Michael Mbega, born again.
Amen.
My spouse is not here, he's in Jamhuri. And I serve the Lord with a ministry or an organization called Leadership Training International.
Yes.
God bless you. I'm Pastor Willie Marble, Petra Life Center. God bless you.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Amen.
Amen.
My name is Pastor Patrick Katope.
I love the Lord as my personal Savior. I serve at Pendle Presbyterian Church, married to one wife. That's my daughter right there. Sarah, can you please wave? I receive the Abrahamic blessing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I have my own Sarah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
My name is Samuel. My wife, I think she's taking care of this guest singer somewhere. I love Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord again.
Amen.
My name is Pastor John Owerro, and I have my spouse right there, my wife.
Amen.
Yes, and we serve with the Emmanuel Worship Center here in St. Louis.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Neighbors. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm Joshua Jama, Reverend Joshua Jama, with International Grad Days Ministries.
Amen.
We are reminding people, amen, there is Grad Days we passed. Mm. We are reviving now to new days.
Amen.
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 My wife is here. If you don't know her, she is here. I am always on journey. That is why we are not together. I am on the way to heaven telling people there is Jesus coming.
Amen.
That is our message.
Yeah, brother, come on.
Woo. That's good. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord. My name is Pastor Joe Kamau. Hello, let me chat.
Oh,
Lord. Oh, my name is Pastor Joe Kamau, and I love the Lord so much. He is my personal Savior. I serve the Lord with the Range and Vane Church just down here, and my wife is like there.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you so much. God bless you. We love you all.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Don't be there. Don't just. Hallelujah. Praise
Amen.
Be to Jesus.
Amen.
My name is Reverend Evan Kugi, born again by the grace of God.
Amen.
We serve with the Fountain of Worship Church in Bridgeton, and we love God.
Amen.
I'm with my dear wife, Susan. Hey, Susan. May God bless you so much.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
My name is Pastor Steve Magua. I serve with the church at the well.
Yeah.
And my wife is on the way because we have many arrows in our quiver. It is full.
Amen.
So she's coming. But I love you all and thank you for being here tonight. The Lord will bless you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
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 These are the men and women of God working in this city.
Amen.
I would like to also introduce myself, Pastor Francis Karenge, not Karenge, or Karenge, but it's Karenge. Amen.
Amen.
Working in Ferguson,
Amen,
Global Christian Center, the Church of the World. With no fear, we are preaching.
Amen.
And we love the Lord.
Yes.
I am glad that most of you, I know you, I have been eating in your house. I have received your mulas in my pocket. Hallelujah. I remember you so much. On my side, I have my queen, Bernadette Karenge. Please may you stand.
Hallelujah.
She is beautiful. Hallelujah. So don't be jealous. Hallelujah. Amen. This time I'd like to a little extend today because I know in the body of pastors, there are also people who really work day and night. I want to appreciate Pastor Sanya and Pastor Steve Magua. Can you come back here a little bit back really quick?
Amen.
Here is Steve Magua. You guys, maybe you don't know him very well. He's from Baltimore, but he resides in St. Louis, St.
Louis,
in a city called Black Jack or Bellefontaine. He is a mobilizer, and he's very zealous for the work of God.
And so he will be quickening.
Why are you guys so quiet and quiet? What next?
All the time, what next? But there is nothing he will do unless he gets orders from us. Amen? He always do. And here is a secretary. He tried to put things together. And I can see his effort.
Yes.
And all the wisdom and the knowledge that he put together. And actually, when we had the what we call breaking news from Nakuru, that, oh, Apostle, I am not coming. We all look to each other. And immediately, we come together.
Amen.
And decide. That is why this is here today.
Amen.
And there are pastors also. They were all over the time, all the time on the phone, trying to connect these things. So secretary tried to call them. Thank you very much on behalf of the pastor. God bless you.
Amen.
Finally, our pastor here, he also involved in our meetings sometimes, but so this is not the first time. So we want to say thank you for your contribution when we came to our visit. Amen?
Amen.
Yeah. And lastly, I want to give thanks to Pastor Paul. Spoke to me while he's in, what is the place? Alberta. This place is
Calgary.
So he called me and said, what's going on? I told him Calgary is good here. So he extended his greetings and say hello to you. And I'm sure he was preaching today this morning in Canada. Amen.
Amen.
So this, Pastor Paul is the man of this place.
Amen.
He's short in what?
Stature.
Ufupi si ugonjwa. Wio. Akona akili, amen?
Amen.
He's not in the guy in Luke chapter 19. So, Zacchaeus was very zealous, but Paul is more than Zacchaeus.
Amen.
Amen? And I can see Pastor James in the back. May you say your name, please? You are very lucky before I go sit down.
Amen.
Can you run forward?
Amen.
Jenks is a man of God from Ghana. He never said that I'm from Ghana. So I like to extend his name. He is from Ghana, but he is a good citizen of this United States of America.
Amen. I don't say because Ghana is part of Africa and I'm from Africa.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But my name is Pastor Jenkins, and I'm the pastor of Bethel Communion Church. And I love the Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. So may we all say thank you to the Lord, especially for this sanctuary that we have been using. I know many people, many pastors will come and say thank you. Thank you, and being grateful is more than $200,000. It's more than $2 million.
Amen.
And I'm glad that you opened the door for us, and you welcome us.
Amen.
And I can tell you how I feel good. Pastor Moshi will tell you how I feel good and how he feels good when we come here. It is not, we don't feel like you're a guest. You can go anywhere, even the office is open. You can use it if you want, no question. But we have to thank God for this property because the Lord has opened the door, amen?
Amen.
Who would ever know one day Africans will buy something like this?
Amen.
So, let's get more than this, amen?
Amen.
Because
hallelujah.
Many people are here. And Brother Young will agree with me, amen?
Yes.
It's time for revival.
Amen.
It's time to come together.
Yes.
It's time to see the anointing of the Lord.
Amen.
Talk is enough.
Yes.
But now walk,
yes.
Walk. Amen?
Amen?
Thank you so much.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Thank you so much, Mr. Chairman. There's a man who gives us orders. When he says stand up, you do what?
Stand up.
Stand up, yeah. He doesn't even call you a name, he just like this and you come to court. So thank you, Mr. Chairman. Actually today we are 20 minutes ahead of time, so we really thank God.
Wow.
Amen.
Miracle.
This is the first time my program and that program, we are ahead of time. So I'm not going to waste any time. We do have a few people that would like them to testify what the Lord has done.
Amen.
Do you remember the testimonies back in Africa?
Yes.
We came here, we forgot, yeah? People even, I was in a place, someone was told to testify. He said, I don't know how to testify. In Boston, a preacher. He forgot. All right. Before we do a dance, because we have Tracy is in the house. Let's appreciate Tracy in the house. But before we do a dance, a Nigerian dance, we do have Young Reed. He's a young man. He is right here. We're going to ask him to come and say what the Lord has done.
Amen.
It's a cowboy, huh? Yeah? Yeah.
There's just something about the anointing of Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
My wife, Penny, we're from Farmington, and we so love the Lord. And we've been a part of the heart of Africa for years. It's amazing how God pulled us out of where we came from and put us in a place of Africa and the African brothers and sisters in the Lord. And God has laid upon my heart dearly about the unity of the brothers and the sisters in the African church. God spoke to me years ago about Africa One. I had no idea what he was talking about. But the unity of the body, when I came here Friday, my heart leaped with joy. Because for the first time I saw God move. In a unity of peace. The revelation of his kingdom is coming, amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
There's going to be a separation of the body, the saints of God are rising up. The church is going to die off, but the saints of God are rising up.
Amen.
And he told me that the African church in St. Louis is a wheel in the middle of the wheel. And you look at the spokes, and oh my, brothers, they reach out to Minneapolis, Kansas City, Dallas. It's amazing what God is doing in St. Louis. He's opening up heaven.
Amen. Amen. Yes. Hallelujah.
And last night, the prophet, oh my goodness. I didn't mean for us to take so much time upon my wife and I. We feel really bad. Not. Because he's faithful.
Amen.
My tomorrow, amen, is to serve the Lord with all of our hearts.
Amen.
But there's been more than one prophet spoke the same thing within the last 6 months from Kenya. He called us up. He said, you're going to go into Europe. You're going to go into South America. So last night, when the man of God spoke over us, it's our tomorrow.
Yes, yes, yes.
I thank you, Pastor Karengi. John, we love you. We love you. We love you. We love the body of Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
God bless you. We have another very powerful testimony. Because God is doing good things.
Amen.
You know, the servant of the Lord does not know all these people. And the way God was using him yesterday, it was amazing.
Yeah.
When he was ministering to one man, I was really moved. Where is Moses?
Amen.
Moses is ready to give a testimony. Come here, Moses.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen. I was so moved that I wanted to sit down. I became powerless because of something else that I know. And then yesterday we were sharing with my friends in the house. I told them, I feel like sitting down. And then Sarah told me, but you sat down right here. I said, I forgot. Power was, I couldn't stand it anymore. But anyway, let him save himself.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
For those who don't know me, my name is Moses Maura. I play drums for this church.
Amen.
And
amen. Amen. Yeah.
What I can say is
amen.
I have been through a lot, to where that when the pastor was praying in my head, I thought somebody was telling him this prior to him praying to me, because I've never experienced something like that. Somebody speaking to me, knowing exactly what it is that's going on, without actually knowing me, because that's the first time I ever saw him. That's probably the first time he ever saw me. So I praise God for what he has done. I do believe that it's over and I am free, and I do feel peace ever since yesterday.
Amen! Hallelujah! Glory! Hallelujah!
I know he's going to do great things. I know he's going to be with me as I keep walking with him.
Yes.
He's going to help me.
Yes.
And just keep praying for me.
Yeah.
I pray for myself.
Yes.
And God will bless you. Thank you.
Amen.
Amen. That's what God can do.
Amen.
You know, the minister talked about a text message he wrote and he wanted to send it. And later on, the mother was being consulted. She said she knows everything else that was said apart from the text message. And the gentleman said the text message he never told anybody. But God told the preacher.
Amen.
Isn't that amazing?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
We know we have many more testimonies. But the dad is saying, don't leave me out. Right, go ahead, come here. As Tracy gets ready now for a dance before we go to our main guest singer. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
I want to take this opportunity to thank all of you who are here, and I also decided to take advantage of the few minutes, Pastor Samuel said, we have ahead of the time. So take advantage of that, honor us if you will. Well, Moses is my son, or our son, because my wife is here.
Amen.
From the heritage as well.
Yeah.
We all need to have one at Pewe Sifa. I know Moses cannot say all, and he might not have the courage to speak and say everything, but it is not possible.